Hey guys, let's see how this works today. The tape is for Zoom. For some reason, the camera zooms in a little differently on Zoom. So let's try this. We'll see how this works today. I'm coming up, trying to come up with a better idea for your guys' notes. So I will see what we can do today. All right. So when describing the distribution of quantitative variables. So we're on page 27 to 29. My suggestion is that you kind of walk through it with us in the book as we talk about it, or read the book ahead of time. So there's an acronym, and it's called SOCS. Okay. So we're going to describe the shape. We're going to describe outliers. We're going to describe the center, and then we're going to describe, my brain just went dead, describe the spread. So we're always describing the shapes, and so we'll get into the different types of shape. There are outliers. Outliers are data points that are far out where they don't need to be. Center, it's usually the mean or the median, and then the spread is how far apart these things are. So we'll kind of jump into looking at some different ideas here. So you guys have this piece in front of you. You have Brian and Jessica decided to move to several different cities, and this is their temperatures in July. So as you guys kind of can see, they bounce all over the place, the different cities, it's labeled correctly. It should say cities here. So these are the different temperatures and different things like that. So when we're talking about shape, just real quick, we're talking about kind of the shape that this thing makes. Don't worry about these little indentations. So these are all shaped correctly. This one's really stretched out. This one, I would start here like this. These are your outliers. These are types of outliers. Okay. This is spread, how far apart they are. Here, our centers are kind of where the peak is. So when we're looking at this graph, a lot of the we'll do that a little steeper here. A lot of the centers are right about the same spot, kind of thing. And then this would come down, and then you probably have some outliers down here like this. So those are possible outliers. These are a little different shape than this one. This is actually called skewed. This is skewed to your left because it looks like your left toe, big toe sticking up. Pinkies are down here, big toes there. This would be skewed to the right, or skewed right, I should say. These are normal or symmetrical. This one is pretty symmetrical. It's just really flat, so could be almost considered uniform because it's almost the same. So those are the ideas when it comes to how you're talking about these things. You know, the center's right around, 90? Most of the centers are right around 80 right here in there somewhere. So let's move on to the second page. So I'll bring this one back. So what is the most important difference between... Here's the key piece. What is the most important difference? That's when we're comparing things. So we're looking for differences between A, B, and C. So if I go back to this graph right here, and I go A, B, and C, they all have the same shape. They all pretty much have the same spread. They don't have any outliers that are sitting outside. So the main thing that we need to change the difference on is the center, because the center tells us that their mean average temperature is 90, 80, and 70. So this city's much cooler. So we're looking for the most important difference on those would be the center. So if we look at the second one, what about C and D? So if we look at C and D, most important difference, center's about the same. The shape is somewhat good. There's not maybe outliers, but not really. So the biggest thing I would say about these two is how far apart they are. So we're talking about the spread. What are two important differences between cities D and E? Definitely the shape. Look at the shape and then an outlier maybe. So we got shape and we've got outliers. So we've got our shape and we've got our outliers. What about C, F, and G? C, F, and G. Those are all basically the same. F, C. Here we go. C, F, and G. Centers are about the same. Maybe outliers, mostly shape. So we're talking about shape. The other ones are skewed, and C is symmetrical. All right, so sorry about the scribbly line. I grabbed the wrong one to see if my pen was working right. My pen, apparently. So we've got shape. Let me go through those again. We've got center. We've got spread. We've got shape and outliers, and then we have shape again. And then we're going to be working on this. So go ahead and create a dot plot and describe what you see there. So create a dot plot and describe what you see. I'm going to create my dot plot right now, but I'm also going to pause this. So that's a quick dot plot. I would have labeled this, but smartphones would be like the number of smartphones. Sorry for the small handwriting, my hand slipped. Number of smartphones, this would be the battery life in minutes. So this is life in minutes. And so there's my spread. So you'd be talking about the spread between 300 and 460 over here. The center is right about here in there somewhere. This one moves it over. Maybe it might be over here a little bit. Outlier. This is definitely possibly an outlier for the HTC Droid. So a couple little things going on there. All right. So let's move to what these things look like. So we are looking at the different types of, symmetrical looks like this. Center's nice in the middle. There's no outliers. Distance on both sides. Skewed to the right. Looks like my right toe. The center is skewed off to the right a little bit. Something like that. And then my left toe. My left toe looks like this. And then comes down faster. So it's off to the my left toe, big toe is right here. So there'll be less data points to the left and more data points to the right. Unimodal is just one mode. So basically one bump. So basically these guys are unimodal also. Bimodal, it looks like this. What you kind of think, it's got two bumps in it like that, like a camel. All right, so that's bimodal. There's two bumps there, and then uniform is something that looks like that. So the center still would be here in the middle. Center would be in the middle. These tend to have skewed, tend to have outliers out here. So watch out for the outliers that are possibly out there. Okay, here we go. Last page, guys, last page. So what I want you guys to do is I want to so what is the most important thing to remember when you are asked to compare distributions? I will let you guys answer that on Edpuzzle. And remember, it's that piece right there. So let's look at this. How do you compare the energy costs? So you would state, I'm not going to write it, the top freezer, the center. So you do like center, outlier, oops, shape, outlier, center, spread. Don't forget shape, outlier, center, spread. So you would compare them. It looks like the top freezer and the side freezer both have a symmetrical shape. It looks like the bottom freezer may be skewed because we've got a lot of drawn out outliers out there and there's a high point here. The bottom freezer is the only one that has outliers. Possible outliers. So as you're describing this, you're writing down the types of things I'm saying. When it comes to center, the center for the top is right there. The center's here. So the side and the bottom have approximately the same center in there somewhere. And the top has a center that's lower for energy cost. So we can say the top freezer has a lower energy cost because its center is to the left of the other two. When it comes to spread, the top is the least spread out and the bottom is the most spread out because it goes from approximately 50 all the way to 150, where the top only goes from 50 to approximately 70. So there's ways to explain those, and that is it for today, guys. You guys are on to homework number 4. Hopefully that worked a little better. I will see you once it loads up.